something else from your friend, the headmaster.
Don't.
Kelly had the right idea. I'd have taken Donna with me last night had we got somewhere else to go.
Where do you think they are?
No idea.
I found this in her room. It's from Tom, his first week in a job.
Oh, this gets worse.
No, he's got his address on. I was thinking maybe they might go back to Aberystwyth. Clear his stuff out on that.
So, what? You turn up on the doorstep, and that's presuming they're still there, which I very much doubt, but let's say they are, and what? He may never get another teaching job again, and she says you've ruined her life. Do you really think they're going to listen to a word you've got to say? Sorry isn't big enough.
I promised to do my hair for Jodie to my Technicolor Dreamcoat. Do you think she'll be back in time? It's just, it starts on the 25th of April.
Well, I don't think so, love.
Oh, is she never coming back?
We don't know.
Why did you do it? How could you be so horrible?
Well, I didn't want her to go. She's too young. I wanted her to stay here with us, you know, till she's old enough to decide what to do for herself.
Didn't. You were just jealous because she was happy and you're not.
I promise you, it wasn't like that. I thought if I made a bit of trouble at school, they'd have to come back here and she'd get fed up with Tom and want to get back with lads of her own age. You know, start being a teenager again.
She'd never give him up. She loves him.
Do you know, you sound just like my dad. Do you know what I did to escape? I married Reg.
Reg? What's he got to do with
it? Don't fight, please.
We're not love. Come here. She'll be all right. Tom will look after her.
But you're our dad. You're supposed to look after us.
Nursing bras. Do you reckon they do nursing bras in Emma's size?
What time does training start?
9.
I suppose you want a lift?
I might not bother.
They might not bother to select you.
What do I say if they ask about Emma?
Tell them it's none of their business.
Yeah, right, that'll shut them up, won't it?
Look, lad, we've enough on our plate without you feeling sorry for yourself.
You'll have to face them sometime.
Hang on.
I'll give you a lift. I'll drop you off.
I'll walk.
I'm going to get it in the net. Have you seen this? 200 quid for a cot.
She won't be needing a cot. Mum and I have talked about this. The best all round is to put the baby up for adoption.
What?
I said no such thing.
What about what Emma wants? Doesn't she get a say?
Emma can't even look after herself. Never mind a baby. This whole business proves it.
You had enough.
I really haven't got the time to listen to this, Chris. Even if I had the inclination.
I've been conned. Conned into buying a duff company. Somebody, Kim's estate, whoever, somebody has to pay.
And can you?
What?
Pay. Court case could ruin you. And you're hardly a candidate for legal aid.
I'm sorry, is this you trying to be supportive?
No, this is me telling you to grow up and move on. Do something positive.
Well, I don't hear you offering to do something positive, like handing me over the deeds and honour my agreement with Kim. No, now you've got your hands on the money, it's every man for himself. Sorry, every person. Did you say something?
No. The stables belong to James. I'll give you first refusal if you can raise the cash.
Don't you ever believe her bleeding heart act, Sophie. It's just pure capitalist muscle.
I'll take that as a no, then.
Every cloud has got a silver lining, eh, James?
Do you know this baby? She's going to make us kings of the road.
Eh? We can't both be kings. You can't have two kings.
It's only an expression, Zach. Oh, all right, Zach. You can be king.
That's better. Hey, you never said you were going to court today.
Do you mind? I'm going to work.
What, at Woolpack?
Dressed like that?
Yeah, it's my new sophisticated image. Understated, chic.
I'll not get far as an understated barmaid, lass. You've got to play to your strengths, Mandy.
Oh, they don't know anything, do they, Lisa? I mean, I bet you don't even know that brown is the new black.
Bad news for snooker players of this world, eh?
Are you going to give me a lift to work or what?
It's time we were off. Come on, jump in. First ride's free today. Oh,
hang on. I'm driving.
No, I'll drive.
Ain't not the first day you want.
I've got key.
I'll toss you for it.
Oh, all right.
Albert, get a move on!
Tails never fails.
Hard lines.
We can't have him sitting up front. He'll scare passengers off.
It doesn't look right.
He's not a people person. He's no experience.
That's what they said about Richard Branson. And look at him now.
She's right, you know. Hey, think I ought to grow a beard then?
We can't both have beards.
Hi.
Not one person has replied to our wedding invitations.
Well, you shouldn't believe all you hear about England being a polite society.
Oh, I don't anymore.
Stop worrying. These things take time. Damn.
What?
My A to Z street map. I got a house clearance 10 minutes ago. It was on the table.
On the shelf.
Why?
I put it there with the others. It makes more sense. I'm trying to help Eric.
Fine. If you want to help, can you open the village hall for the delivery men?
I'm meant at home, not work.
This isn't work. All you have to do is open the door and lock it when they're finished. Then you can come home and help all you want.
Sure.
Sure.
Even though she's dead, she's still playing games with us. Leaving everything to me and James and playing Chris and I off against each other.
Maybe. Or maybe she chose what's best for her son. Much as I hate her for what she's done to me, I can't fault her where he's concerned.
But, Dad, all this business stuff is too much. I've got James and the practice, and I'm barely dreading water.
Get Steve in. Officially. Make him the company manager. I mean it, Zoe.
Do you trust him?
Do I trust anyone? I trust him more than I do your brother. If you want my advice, you'll keep Chris out of things as much as you can.
I think he's got other things on his mind.
What's he done now? I knew he was up to something.
I suppose you'll find out sooner or later. Before Kim died, she sold the livery business to Chris.
Did you know about this?
No, of course not. But wait, it gets worse. He paid her £300,000 in cash.
Cash from where?
Who knows? Only now the money has disappeared. Didn't get paid into her bank account, wasn't featured in her will. Gone. And the contract she signed confirming all this, it's... well, it's a forgery. It's not her signature.
He's lying. He's making out that he's lost big bucks because he wants to screw some out of you. That explains it. He's put in for a visiting request this afternoon.
But, Dad, if you had seen his face at the will reading and after he tackled Kim's solicitor, I swear to you, he thought the deal was straight. And now he's shelled out all that money for nothing. Oh, you'd blow your top.
And to think I wasn't there to see it. Oh, there's no justice in this world.
Quick as you can, we'll run a schedule. Oh, happy day. Careful.
I ask you.
Come on now.
Will you get on a bus with Mr. Magoo?
Oh,
he's a flaming hazard.
I can see perfectly well, thank you very much. I can see from here you've not washed your neck.
Well, I'm local. I know the score. I should be driving.
Ah, well, a fresh face will be good for trade.
But folk like what they know. And they know me.
Ah, for a twisty face beggar and a crook.
Hey!
Ready when you are, Father.
Oops. Oh, hello again.
Me, a crook? I'm not the one just out of nick. He's the weasel of the family. Just like his lad.
Hey, and we've just put him in charge at takings.
Hey! Oh!
All I want is for us to go in there saying the same thing, that's all.
The problem is not going to go away, no matter how much we humour her.
I'm not humouring her, I just think she needs time to recover.
And the longer we leave it, the more chance of some busybody doctor poking his nosing and getting her to bond with the baby.
Mr. and Mrs. Cairns?
Yes? Are you a doctor?
No, I'm Joan Barnes. I work for social services.
Please tell me. If you'll excuse us, we're in a bit of a hurry.
I appreciate that, but we do need to talk. Would you like to come through?
Thanks, but we don't need a social worker.
You might not, but Emma does, and so does her baby.
Perhaps we could have a chat later, after we've seen her.
A chat with the police would be more useful. Find out who raped my daughter.
Have you spoken to Emma about this?
Of course.
Well, so have I. and she made it very plain to me she wasn't raped.
She's 13 years of age. She's 3 years below...
The police will follow up that angle. Don't worry on that score. But at this end, I think it's very important that we are all clear we're not dealing with a case of rape as such. Emma consented to sex.
And that makes everything all right, does it? At 13?
No. But it does make a difference. Look, would you like me to come in with you? Sometimes it's easier...
If there's a stranger present, I've never found that to be the case.
Look, Joan, thanks for the offer, but we're not going to broach anything too heavy yet. We just wanted to know that we're here for her and that we love her. And that's it for today. Okay?
Sure. But you know where I am?
Yes. And thanks.
Joan.
It's called playing the game, Tony, and you better learn how to do it.
Meaning?
Meaning the days of bawling orders and expecting everybody to jump her over. And that goes for Emma as well.
Well, maybe if you'd bawled a few more orders, this would never have happened. I'm sorry, I didn't mean it.
Is that what it's going to be like? Am I going to get blamed for everything?
No, it isn't, I promise.
Because it cuts both ways, you know. Maybe if you'd been around a bit more, it wouldn't have happened.
Becky, I'm sorry. Can we stop this? We're here to see Emma.
Oh, I'm glad you remembered.
Hello.
It's a question of bottle, and I don't just think she's got it.
Really?
Don't get me wrong, Dad. You know, I think the world of Zoe as a kid's sister, but as managing director of the company, she's not her father's daughter, put it that way.
She's just got her own style, that's all.
Do you know she's planning to sell off the livery company? Just like that? Without a word to either of us?
How do you know?
Let's just say I have my sources. But don't worry, I've got a plan.
You usually do.
She wants it sold. I have no authority to stop her. But if you could authorize a loan, I could act on your behalf and buy it back. Keep the whole estate intact.
How much would that be?
Ballpark figures? 700 thou, give or take. But you have to agree, it's vital to keep it in the family. Anyway, enough of business. How are you?
Give this man an Oscar. You've been rumbled, son. You're a lying, conniving little traitor, and you're finished.
Dad.
Now, you listen to me. I haven't got a clue how you got your hands on that money or how you're ever going to pay it back. But I do know that I don't give two hoots.
Please.
It's sink or swim time for you, son, because you're not going to get a brass farthing out of me, or Zoe, for that matter. So didn't even bother to ask. You'll have to try a new tack, like honest graft for once in your life.
Park your backside, Terry. I'm in the chair. Why, Miss Moneypenny.
Do you like it?
Very classy. Hey, Mr. Turner?
Very smart. Very becoming.
Oh, stop it. You'll have me blushing. Now, what can I get you?
Ooh, don't tempt me. It's only 1 o'clock. Two pints of lager, please.
Right.
Bumped into your ex last night.
It's taken the bubbles out of my drink.
He rather clumsily implied he was having money problems.
What a coincidence. As soon as I bring up the subject of divorce, he's suddenly strapped for cash. And who does he decide to tell? You. He must think I was born yesterday.
Hey, up. Bandits at 6 o'clock.
What loser,
Brad? Who do you think he is, Nigel Mansell?
Oh!
brown trousers on fit.
She's over the moon when we bought her this. No, look, she just left it.
As soon as we shut the shop, I'm going looking for her.
Oh, Vic.
I don't care what you say, I've got to try.
And leave Donna on her own, and when we get back, she's gone too. It's pointless, Vic. She's 16. She can do what she likes. Let's face it, she didn't want to be here. You just made it easier for her to go.
God, what a mess.
Oh, that's all I need.
Just like a word.
Liar, that's a word.
Please, Viv, just 5 minutes. Please.
What's he up to now?
£50 each, please, my darlings. Thanks, I'll just get your tickets. It's care in the community. Is he bothering you, ladies?
Yes, he is.
Right. Come on, you.
Ah! Ah.
Look, I know I'm probably the last person in the world you want to see right now.
No flies on you.
Well, I just wanted you to know that if there's anything I can do, you must be gutted about Kelly.
I tell you what gutted me. You. Lying about having another woman just to get rid of me. It's only ever a one-night stand with Ellen, wasn't it? See, you're not even man enough to admit it.
I just thought it would make things easier.
Oh, how? I broke up my marriage for you. I gave up my home. I nearly lost my kids. Don't you think I deserve the truth?
Viv.
What are you doing? I thought you came over to make me feel better. Make yourself feel better, more like.
Do you want me to stay or what?
You broke my heart. And Kelly's gone and done the same thing, but at least she wasn't a coward about it. Get out.
Hi, honey, I'm home. My God.
I brought some things over from the hall.
So I see.
The hangings are mine. What do you think?
Well, it's certainly busy.
Not too much.
No. No.
Good. I've been useful then. Tea?
You can have a cup of tea. I think I'll have a large scotch. What was that for?
It's like the house really has some of me in it now. Yeah. Are you going to smile? Please smile.
You couldn't wait, could you? You don't change. You always wear a grass. Running off to tell Daddy what a naughty boy I've been. You know, I humiliated myself in that place today.
Good.
The irony is, I was trying to stick up for you.
Oh, well, you must have been after something then.
Please don't start arguing. It's not fair on James.
Shut it, Mary Poppins. I could cheerfully strangle you.
Right, that's enough. I've had as much as I can take from you.
Oh, please. You're an employee here.
You're not far off it yourself.
Oh, that's right. Run after her.
To be a millionaire.
I do. Sing along. He's hiding something.
Aye, half the turkins probably. Frisk him, Lisa.
I do no such thing.
Hey, you can frisk me whenever you like.
Whoa. Hey, what's the split?
I told you, straight out middle.
Oh. Well, I could get used to this arrangement. Eh? Them doing all the work and us doing all the collecting.
I beg your pardon?
Ah. There's bed and board. Times two. Plus, parking facilities for the bus.
Hey?
These overheads do creep up.
Right, let them eat cake. Battenberg's been over.
Right,
that is it! You and you! I am sick of this bickering. I thought this was supposed to be a family business now. Shake hands and make up.
Joking.
I said, shake hands! Oh. Unless you want both your gear sticks snapping off.
Thanks. It's really nice of you to bring me out for a drink.
Oh, I have a vested interest.
Look, Sophie, we'd be completely lost if you left us. I'm really sorry. This must be the job from hell.
No. Well, put it this way. I've really grown to love James, and I'd hate to have to leave him, but I have to be honest, it's your brother.
Let me get us another bottle. I've got a proposition that could make things easier for both of us.
Must be catching on. Boss is treating their staff after work.
Do you think you could mention it to Eric Pollard? Oh,
she deserves it. She doesn't stop. Same again, please, Terry.
So how's it going?
Action-packed as ever. I saw Dad today. Be good if you and I could have a talk soon.
I look forward to it.
Right, that's enough shop talk. Let's order. I'm starving.
Thanks.
Oh, she's so demanding.
So, what's this big idea?
Well, I need to move back home. I've got to get nearer to the surgery.
Oh, no, please don't leave me on my own with Chris.
Well, that's the proposition. Why don't you and James come to live with me? I know Dad would approve, but it means that we can both escape the horrors of life with my brother. What do you say?
Oh, and I had a letter from Trish Farnell about all the goings-on on the base.
What? Has Pete found out about the Christmas party?
You shouldn't be filling your head with all that nonsense.
Dad, don't be a pranny. I'm not a kid, you know. Do I have to stay here tonight?
Yes, you do, but you can come home very soon.
Will everything be back to normal?
Well, as normal as we can make it, considering your father's home permanently now.
We're going to have to make some decisions soon.
Yes, well, we're going to have to go, Sam.
No, don't. I hate it here on my own. I just want you to stay and talk.
We could talk about the baby.
Tony.
I don't want to. They keep asking me if I want to see it. I don't. I don't have to, do I?
No, you don't have to. We've seen her. Will, Charlie and I.
Have you?
We're all in this together, Emma. But we are going to have to talk about what's going to happen to her.
There's nothing to talk about. I hate it. It's ruined my life and everybody's angry with me now. Yes, you are. Please, Mum, you decide. Get it taken somewhere. There are plenty of people who can't have babies. One of them can have it. It's only fair. I don't even want to see it. I just want to come home and be normal again.